what should we as teachers do for education for the future? So what we must be doing is we must be sure that we are equipped with the skills and knowledge required to function in the world of tomorrow. So it is time for us to get equipped with the different knowledge and skills required. So teaching digitally, it is not as difficult as this picture shows. It is not very difficult. I would like to now just talk about what Alvin Toffler says about schools of tomorrow. He says, in a school of the 21st century, a school here means our educational institutions. They should be open 24 hours a day. We must be able to provide students customized educational experiences. Students can arrive at different times. They can begin their formalized schooling at different ages. And the curriculum is integrated across different disciplines. Non-teachers work with teachers. When I mean non-teachers, they could be from the field of technology, they could be from any other field who start working with teachers. So teachers will start working with the school and in the different business world. So business people will have a say in the schools and schools will have a say in the business. That is, we will have no barriers like we have today. So these are the ideas which I was trying to put across. So if anybody has any questions, they could have put it in the chat box. I would go through the chat box and if necessary, I'll hand it over back to the organizers. Thank you so much for listening to me.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for your valuable presentation. It's a really wonderful presentation, ma'am. You expressed your views on the present day situation, teaching and learning experiences, and we really need such kind of skills to update ourselves, to equip ourselves in the future, in the near future. Thank you so much, ma'am. I now invite Dr. Radhika to take up the question and answer session. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. This is Dr. Radhika. Ma'am, you are I have gone through so many ages since ancient time to till modern time. How is the education? And we actually felt the presence of the education in before us actually. So how it is going to be in future? It's definitely very clear from your presentation, and actually you gave a definite and specific answer to the challenges of education tomorrow, that it is going to be 24 hours a day, like it is going to be for a shift system, or it is going to blend with business, everything. It's so nice and killer presentation, ma'am. Thank you so much for your valuable information, and we gained a lot, and we gained a lot of knowledge from your presentation, and we are really grateful to your nice presentation, ma'am. Thank you so much. And now we'll see, ma'am, any questions from the audience. I'll just put it on. Audience, if you have any questions, please put it in the chat box. Or can we mute one or two our participants if they want to ask directly to the ma'am question?
Ma'am, can we
do that, ma'am?
Yeah, sure, we can. Please.
So, dear participants, if any one of you wants to ask a question, you just unmute yourself and ask the madam the question by you, so that ma'am will answer you directly.
Yeah, I can see one question in the chat box by Mr. Yes. Ravikiran. How COVID-19 is driving along overdue revolution in education?
Yes.
So the comment he has made, I think.
Yes.
Education is going to be revolutionized. It's not going to be the same. That's what I was trying to say. It is not going to be the same. We are not going to go back into post-COVID era into the same type of classrooms. Definitely there will be changes. And as I said, technology will not replace you, but those who know technology will replace those who do not know technology. That's it. I can see only one ma'am.
Audience, do you have any questions to ask? Actually, Bam has given a very nice presentation so that you can have a good availing of things from her. So, let us have a question from the audience. This is Sharara Ijustaju. Anita Gaddikate, she is asking one question. It's an upgrading experience. It's not a question, actually.
How could COVID be driving?
Okay, I think nobody has any questions.
There is a question from Ravi Kiran. How COVID-19 is driving a long overdue revolution in education?
That I answered, no? Again, he has asked, how smart classrooms are transforming India's education system?
Yes, ma'am.
How? See, when you start taking the smart classrooms and you start working on them, you will realize how great it is. See, when it was only the chalk and the blackboard, then we had our system of overhead projectors where we would sit and draw our and write our OHP sheets. Then we shifted to PowerPoint. The next digitalization will be smart classrooms. So once you have smart classrooms, you can have all your presentations in 3D and you will not waste a lot of time sitting and writing on the blackboard, whereas you can do it digitally. So as I was going through this, when people were asking post-COVID, what will you do and all that, I was also feeling, since we are in the 50 plus age bracket people, maybe we will be left out. So I have joined two FDP programs with my maiden name without professor, because the minute I put professor, they are not giving me admission into FDP. So I put out the professor tag and have joined two courses where now at least, after joining it, I know all the terms, the technology terms, but how far we are able to use them, time will tell. But definitely we will have to think of online learning, e-learning, how to do video lessons, how to do podcasting, how to present material, how to make your own modules, how to make your own MOOCs courses. So this is the challenges of tomorrow, where all of us will have to change. We'll have to start picking up the skills and so that we will not be left behind. And also the other thing we need to do is, in addition to our getting trained, we'll have to train the next generation, because their generation cannot take refuge into the thing that we don't know. They are going to be into that world. So they have to be given that opportunity. So smart classrooms is one aspect. Other thing is, we have to be ready for all other technological changes which we are going to get across.
Thank you, ma'am. Nice answer. And there is one question from Bhavani.
Yes, ma'am.
During this pandemic COVID, higher education, especially research and development, facing problems regarding coursework for research scholars. Yes. How can we deal with such difficulties?
Yes, this is, as even Vishwesh Rao sir said, yes, unprecedented. Yes. It is not something that anybody knows or has an experience.
Question right or not, leda nagu.
So when you are having research, science research is definitely going to be a problem because you need labs. You cannot do it sitting from home. Social science, for one way, if you are going to stick only to the online resources, research can't be done. I am also guiding students. So what are we doing? We said, stop collecting data. Let us write the chapterization. Let us write chapters. The next question is, madam, for chapters, I don't get access to library. I don't get books. Yes, this is unprecedented, and all of it, maybe we'll have be having our researchers going 6 months back. We can understand it, but what best we can do is maybe review of literature somewhere where we can have some discussion. And in social sciences, what we were doing as questionnaires.
Ma'am, just can you unmute, ma'am?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yes,
ma'am. So I don't know when I got muted.
Yes, ma'am.
So research definitely is taking a beating, and we will be back by another. We will lag behind by 6 months to 8 months till it really comes back to normal. So we'll have to keep our students motivated by trying to do whatever activities. I was telling you, we are actually now doing our questionnaires, giving our data for data collection through Google Forms. Instead of doing it offline, we would go to the people and give it. Now we are trying to get it online. So some changes we'll have to make even in research.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Shivaram is asking, what are the challenges and strategies for online learning?
Yeah, I listed the challenges, like how to get across the digital divide, how to may become digital literate, how to start learning the techniques, how to be using them. So these are our challenges. And what are the strategies? I said one strategy I just now said was, I have joined an FTP program on how to teach online through online. So that's a program I'm attending for the last 4 days. So continuously, I'm also sitting and opening my laptop, opening my mobile, listening to the mobile, doing the practical work on my laptop. I honestly would tell you that I never did anything other than word processing and data processing on my laptop or system before COVID, before March. I knew only for emailing, for doing word processing and doing some data processing in Excel sheets. Today, world has changed for me. I have understood. I may not have made a video lesson till now. I have done video lesson where it was recorded through the manually. So now we have to change. The strategies are teachers have to be trained how to use it. As soon as we come back to normal, we have to get trained. There are so many online courses, so many free courses available on our Swayam platform, which we should join, so many free of cost, so we can sit at home, at our confines of home and start learning. So we have to get our skills ready. So the strategies are for online learning, get your skills ready, whether it is podcasting, whether it is preparing the courses, whether it is using different tools, whether you are using Google Classroom, whether we are using Zoom Classroom, how are we using the classroom? How are we motivating the students? Simple, there is just a WhatsApp group in which every day I talk to my students, and there is something we put there so that we are motivating each other. So whatever be these techniques, I think that we have to be ready. Yes?
Ma'am, really you are a real motivator to all of us actually, because you are being a student to learn. Now also you are learning so much of things and technological sophisticated knowledge. It's really appreciable and it's really motivating to all of us, ma'am. Excellent. And we congratulate you, and we convey our best regards to you on this occasion. And this is Dr. Radhika signing off, ma'am. It's
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable sharing of knowledge. As you mentioned while presentation, we need to know how to create content and how to share content. That's a teacher should have that kind of skills. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your wonderful session. We have received so many compliments from the participants, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity to meet all my friends. Some of them, I would have loved to come to Machilipatnam and met them personally, because I can see their names on the list. But anyhow, through webinar, through this, I have connected, though I have not talked to you personally. Maybe sometime we should connect so that we can see all of you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us. Thank you, ma'am. Now, I'd like to invite our beloved registrar, Professor K. Krishna Reddy Garu, for closing remarks. Sir, registrar Garu.
I'm audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Continue, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, your voice is breaking, sir.
I'm audible too.
Yes, it is audible, you. Sir.
I am audible to you.
Yes, sir.
Jyotirmayi.
Yes, sir.
Please, ma'am. Okay. Thank you. At the outset, at the outset, we are
lift the meeting now.
Full presentation on the on the topic. కొద్ది ఆపేరని చెప్తా. ఓకే, పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ త్రూ ది ఆన్లైన్ యాక్టివిటీ. బట్ వాట్ ఐ అండర్స్టూడ్ త్రూ ది డ్యూరింగ్ ది COVID-19, the mainly even the online classes which we are conducting, honestly speaking, we talk voluminously and we make the outputs are so low. In our system now, we are conducting huge number of webinars, FTP programs and everything. If you see the real outcome, the messages what we are getting, the way we are conducting. So on that day we will say that this webinar is excellent, and next day we'll forget about everything. The students are still not able to understand what we are giving the lessons to them. Because if you see the student side, we don't have this proper bandwidth, we don't have the proper communication system, audio video, then how a student can have these two? So we have to think, as the first presentator informed, we must be cautious, because these public universities are run by the governments, and the students whom are coming to us are the below poverty level, BPL. So we must be in a position to take care of them and provide the proper infrastructure to them. Then only we have to start the online classes, and it may be successful based on the virtual activity. But as the COVID situation is getting grim, and we have to look for the alternatives apart from the webinar, and how to cope up with the next level of thinking is more required. Now the present situation over the overwhelming response for only the webinars, I personally feel, apart from the webinar, we have to motivate the student even through phone line. Our voice is also, I feel, is one of the activity we can do with them, apart from your WhatsApp grouping and also providing the MOOCs, SWAYAM and their NPTEL. So everybody talks more. We'll say MIT, and many people say that America and Europe, they are in ahead and we are behind. These are all only to push by ourselves that we know everything. So I have seen the globe. I have been many places. I have seen all the educational systems across the globe. What we need is our educational system is the best. So we have to follow our own methods, our own strategies, our own planning, our own cultured activities. Then only our educational system, especially the higher educational system, will sustain forever. If we go on with the alien activities, with the foreign activities, with the others, other path, we see the internet, you get the voluminous data on any topic, and we follow that one, and we say that is the great. So I personally feel that in the higher education system, we have to use our own methodologies that we will discuss maybe in the next coming sessions. Maybe one of our colleagues from our own institutes may take up, and they will definitely will give the solution for these kind of challenges what the COVID-19 is posing to us. And also we have to think for this academic year, how best we can do justice to the wards, our wards, not only from the Krishna University and also for other institutions. We are really a compact university, and we are having 24 teachers are available, and with the young chaps around 50 plus we are working. So we will definitely do the justice for the academics, some extent to the research in the coming days to come. I really thank the organizers, the Department of Journalism, and especially Dr. Jyotirmay Garu, who gave me this wonderful opportunity, and I wish her the best of luck, and hoping that she will continue to conduct few more webinars. And I also sincerely thank the participants who are large number participated, about 20 plus are now on the online, 44 is made registrations. And especially the two eminent speakers were given lots of information that is highly useful for us as a reference and guidance. With this, we have to go ahead in the next coming days ahead. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ananda. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wishes and your motivation. Thank you a lot for your support and encouragement. Thank you so much for being with us, sir. And I request all the participants to submit your feedback form. It is provided in the chat box within 15 minutes. I request all the participants to submit the feedback form within 15 minutes of it is provided in the Telegram app also. Thank you, participants. And now I like to invite Dr. P. Vijayalakshmi Garu, Assistant Professor in the Department of Journalism and Mass Communication, to propose vote of thanks. Thank you. Ma'am, please continue, ma'am.
Madam, thank you, ma'am.
డాక్టర్ విజయలక్ష్మి, కెన్ యూ అన్మ్యూట్ యువర్ ఆడియో మ్యామ్? I request Dr. Vijayalakshmi to unmute your audio. Let's leave the meeting. Yes, she's trying. I'm continue, ma'am. You are not audible, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. You are audible. Continue.
Yeah. Good evening to all of you. On behalf of the Department of Journalism and Mass Communication, Krishna University, and Dr. K. Jyotirmayi, head of the department, and other faculty members of the department, I propose a vote of thanks to all the speakers, faculty, and participants. First of all, I thank our respectable Vice Chancellor, Professor K.B. Chandrasekhar Garu, for his unstinted support to the development of our department and in organizing this webinar on education in the context of COVID-19 challenges and innovations. Our heartfelt thanks to you, sir. I would like to express our sincere thanks and gratitude to our registrar, Professor K. Krishna Reddy Garu, for his encouragement and motivation for conducting this webinar. The department also extend appreciation and thanks to our principal, Professor N. Usha, for joining the webinar. Now, I express my gratitude to our eminent speaker, Professor P. L. Vishweshwar Rao, my teacher for the last 30 years. Sir, we are grateful to you for sharing your intellectual resources and how COVID-19 raised new challenges for the education field, like reading books, employability skills, and training online teaching, and also other challenges. And I also thank Professor Vanaja Madam for her excellent presentation on digital literacy. And it is very detailed and also clear, Madam. It is very simple. Thank you very much, Madam, for your presentation. And I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Narayan Rao, Principal KBN College, for extending technical support. I would also like to place on record our thanks to Dr. Ramesh, Faculty of Computer Science, and his team effort in taking care of the technical issues. And finally, I thank all the guests, faculty members of all universities, and also participants for their active participation. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your vote of thanks. I thank Dr. Radhika. She is a psychologist, well-known psychologist. Thank you, ma'am, for your support and thank you for your support, ma'am. Thank you so much. With this, we'll close the session. Please, I request all the participants to submit a feedback form within 10 minutes. Thank you so much. Thank you, participants, for your active participation in the webinar and make this webinar a successful one. Thank you so much. Awesome.